Hi everyone, I'd like to talk about how to get a good quality stereo signal from a keyboard and a lapel mic for, in my case, teaching piano online. I've had various problems with this, and there is some software out there that allows you to route various bits of audio for Zoom, but I've had problems with the signal sometimes coming out in mono only, or it's come out distorted. So the solution I found is to use Loopback Audio, which is a commercial product, but it's the only thing I've found to give a good result. So this is all for the Mac, Apple Mac. So in basic terms, I've got a piano in stereo, and I've got the lapel mic, and I want that to be sent over Zoom in stereo. So what have I got? I've got a Focusrite Scarlett. And you can see that I've got an XLR mic for the lapel mic. And the other inputs I've got left and right for my Nord keyboard. So what I'll do now is go over to the computer and just show you how it looks like in Zoom. So let's look at the audio setup using Loopback Audio, which is the software I'm using to manage the audio routing. You can see I've got the Scarlett 4i4 interface up here, and channel one is the lapel mic. And using the audio cables here, sort of virtual cables, I've routed that to channel one and two, the stereo output, which I'll use in Zoom. Channels three and four are coming from the Nord keyboard. And they will be routed into the same mix. It is possible using Loopback to add other devices, so you can add QuickTime Player or anything that produces audio into that mix. Let's go into Zoom, and you'll see that if I go down here to the audio setup, I've got Zoom Mix as the microphone. So let's do some audio tests and double check what we've got here in Zoom. So Zoom Mix, which is what I was just showing you on Loopback. Now, what I'd like to do is just show you what it was like before I used Loopback. I was just using the Scarlett as the input. So you can still hear the mic. You can still hear the keyboard, hopefully. The one thing that was different is that stereo doesn't work. Even if you've got it enabled in Zoom, stereo was not happening. So let's just test that. I can put a delay, a ping pong delay on the sound. So you should hear it. You should, if it was stereo, hear it bouncing between left and right. So I'll just play something. Now that will be in mono. What I'm going to do is go to Zoom Mix, which is the Loopback mix. And if I do exactly the same thing, you should hear that in stereo. So that's a big improvement. And irrespective of the actual delay, obviously, if you have a, let's say you had a sound with a particular effect, reverb, it just sounds better. So you get a much nicer kind of sound. Okay, so the other thing to remember is always turn on original sound in Zoom. So that means that the sound isn't compressed. And yes, that's basically it. So I think this is a way of getting a pretty good sound. It does mean you have to use a plugin, piece of software, but I think it's a good solution to, if you want the flexibility for doing podcasting or teaching where sound's a real, really important thing, this is a good option. So I hope that was useful.